Hello everybody and welcome to NEET Mentor. In this particular session, we are going to talk about the proceeding for MCC counseling process. The counseling process for MCC round 1 is going to start for today, which means the registration process will start today and you can do the registration. The choice filling and all the things will be starting from tomorrow 26th. And we are going to discuss many things related to rules and which are the colleges. There are some common doubts, or I can tell you FAQs. The clarification will be done on based on the brochure that published, how the DNB counseling is going to be conducted, what will the impact of DNB and All India Quota counseling getting clubbed together, and how you should do the choice filling, what should be the strategy to do the choice filling, impact of OBC and EWS reservation, and is it going to be final, and how it is going to impact positively and negatively to particular candidates. Our rules and regulations regarding round 1, round 2, upgradation rule, and what are the scenarios after round 2, how we are going to balance out the All India counseling round 1, round 2, and state counseling round 1, round 2, the schedule or like sequence of All India counseling and state counseling. So there are many other queries like do private colleges participate in All India counseling. There are many basic queries coming from candidates, so that all the queries I'm going to cover up to the my memory as I remember. Okay, and in case you want to avail our paid guidance services, because the time has come when you are in the action, it's not about the planning or anything. The planning part is already done. Okay, now we have to perform the action. You must have thought like what to do and which colleges to select and which branches to select and what is the probability. Okay, so for paid counseling guidance, you can consult us on 9319128677. Okay, in case the call is not picked, because we'll be busy serving our paid members, and this video is also important for paid members. Even though I will be creating separate videos which will guide you through the process, and you can call on another number also 8076051875. You can also send us WhatsApp messages in case the call gets coming busy. Okay, and I request all of you to keep patience, because we have got so many days. Up to 29th the registration can be done. So let's get started, and if you like the content of the video, you hit the like button, and let's start with the all the queries. So the question number one, when can you start your registration? See, the registration is starting from today 25th, but you can do your registration and choice filling on the same day, means any day between 25th of means today until 29th 12 until 29th you can do the registration. Okay, any day between 25th to 29th. Okay, the timing, everything is given, so I just suggest all of you to have that screenshot, okay, in your mobile phone or your desktop. Okay, in order to do the process for choice filling and registration process, you should use laptop or desktop. Avoid using mobile phone, because the sites won't be behaving exactly same way on mobile phones and on desktop, even though they have designed it properly, but still it's better to use laptop or desktop. Okay, so you can do the registration on tomorrow or day after tomorrow before 29th, but I suggest you to keep all the registration process and choice filling done 2 days before. Okay, next question, it required to lock the choices. Locking choices in All India counseling is not mandatory. Automatically, even you don't lock it, it will get automatically locked, okay, on the last moment. Okay, it's very important not to lock the choices, so that you have the liberty to change the sequence in case you have some different planning or some other priorities, or you get to know about particular college feedback later, so that after locking you are not permitted to change anything. Third question is, what is the tuition fee, what is the registration fee and security deposit you need to pay. So there are two amounts. One is non-refundable security registration fee. So as you can see on the screen, 1,000 rupees for all India quota, Central Universities, UR and EWS candidates, and 500 for SC, ST, OBC and PWD candidates. 5,000 is the registration fee for deemed university candidates. What in case, and there is a refundable security deposit also. For all India quota, Central University DSIC for general category candidates is 25,000 is the security deposit, which is refundable. Okay, for SC, ST, OBC, PWD is 10,000. Okay. And for deemed universities, you want to participate for deemed universities is 2 lakhs. Okay. In case you are going for deemed universities and all India both, then you have to pay only security deposit of 2 lakhs and the registration charges of 5,000. So 2 lakhs, 5,000. Okay. Next question. Let me just clarify all the questions that I have in my mind. Okay. So candidates are really confused. They ask whether the private colleges counseling will also happen through All India Quota. See, in All India Quota, or you call it MCC, both are same. Okay, so MCC conducts the counseling process for 50% government seats from all the states. That is one. Second, all the central universities, CIP Ranchi, 100% seats from CIP Ranchi, and for other central universities like AMU, Delhi University, Indraprastha University or BHU, 50%. Remaining 50% seats is reserved for internal quota. So what is meaning of internal quota? Those candidates who studied from those universities, they completed their MBBS from those universities, are coming under internal quota and they should have completed the internship on time. So that's prerequisite. Third thing is deemed university. Okay, so deemed universities are those universities which are not coming under any state authority, any college in Karnataka, private college like Vaidehi, Ramayya. These are private colleges, any college in Rajasthan or any college in Uttar Pradesh. Okay, these are state private colleges and the counseling will happen separately. You need to register separately for Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Karnataka. I'm just giving example. These colleges won't take participate in All India counseling. It won't be part of deemed university. Okay, so I think most of the candidates are confused. They are targeting to get admission in like particular Ramayya College and they are looking for Ramayya College in the seat matrix that got published, but you won't find it. Only deemed universities, and deemed universities is equal for all of them. Even you qualified in OBC, still you are eligible for deemed university and your category won't apply there. You will be not given any reservation. So I think that's point clear. And even you come from Karnataka and there is a Karnataka deemed university like GSS, KLE Belgaum, KMC Manipal, Mangalore. Okay, so even you come from Karnataka, you have done your MBBS from Karnataka, your domicile of Karnataka state, you don't get any extra benefit in the deemed universities which are located in Karnataka state. It's all equal for all of the candidates across India. Okay, so that's another doubt. Next thing, let me scroll through the slide and then I should be able to tell the next one. Let's talk about AFMC. Okay, so on how you need to do registration. First of all, you need to visit on mcc.dink.in. This is the official site where you need to do the registration for AFMC counseling. You can only do the registration on mcc.nic.in. just registration, you don't you can't do anything extra the counseling. Okay, so you are allowed to do registration for FMC through mcc.nic.in. the counseling process will get conducted by FMC authorities, okay, at their own as per their rules and regulations. The role of MCC is limited just to registration for the willing candidates. MCC shall not be responsible for any allotment process on behalf of AFMC. So you can't make the queries to MCC regarding AFMC counseling. So you need to visit AFMC website before applying. Okay, and there are some other like other criteria that you need to fulfill, like eligibility criteria related to your medical. Okay, so in case you fulfill, then only should apply for FMS counseling. Else after allotment of the seat also you might get your seat cancelled. Okay, moving to the next question. Is there any discrepancy in the, if there is any discrepancy in the spelling name of the document and application form? So application form you filled the name and you filled the name wrongly, or any kind of a spelling mistake, this is very understood, then what you should do? If there is any discrepancy in a spelling mistake, then what you can do? You must carry a proof like affidavit or undertaking that the documents belonging to the same person. Okay, next question. After you do the choice filling, you should get the choice preference printed so that you do double check. Okay, it happens many times. I am giving the practical example. You are going for general medicine and you select accidentally community medicine. See what happens, sometimes the server will be behaving slowly and you assume that you selected general medicine, but since it's slow, it get some other link gets clicked without your knowledge. So that becomes a big mistake for you if you get some non-clinical or some lower clinical branch selected due to some mistake. So it's very mandatory that you match all the choice preferences couple of times, you get the print out, and then you match it whichever you have selected, is it particular order or the branch is having some different name or not. So there might be chance of some manual error, human error. Okay, so now I will discuss like how the negative impact OBC and EWS. You need to watch the video until end because it's FAQ session, you can't skip it, otherwise your question which is relevant to you might be missed. I'm randomly taking the questions and I from my own list. Okay, so next question I will talk on is how OBC and EWS reservation is going to be. So as per the seat matrix, they have given the OBC and EWS seats as well. Okay, and more than 2400 seats are given for OBC. So 2400 plus seats are allotted to OBC category. So definitely for general candidates it will be negative shift. Okay, and they will get impacted. Now how it is going to impact DNB? So those candidates who are not likely, who were expecting to get a medicine seat or any pediatric seat, if they don't get that, then they will also go for, since it's clubbed counseling, they will also go for medicine branch in DNB. So due to reservation, if they don't get seat in MD medicine, they will get seat in DNB medicine. So those candidates who were targeting for DNB particularly based on their rank, assuming that they won't be getting MD medicine, their chances will be they will be having like a loss due to this reservation and due to club of All India quota, government colleges and DNB. So it's going to impact both MD and DNB, MSMD and DNB both will be impacted negatively. But those candidates coming from OBC or EWS category, they will get a handsome benefit of like depending on the branches, like 1000 to 3000 positive shift. Okay, and it will also impact your state counseling. See how it's going to be the sequence. The first round of let me take this question and then I will move ahead. If I opt to participate in second round counseling, whether my allotted seat will be cancelled? No. See, if you are getting upgraded, okay, if your seat is getting upgraded, then only your first round seat will be cancelled and you need to join the new college which is better as per your preference. In case you don't get upgraded, you will still be having the seat allotted in round one. Okay. So now the question number, these all are like some important points, that's why I taken the screenshot, so that even you can take a screenshot of it and it will be for your future reference. So DNB is how, let's discuss how DNB is going to be conducted. DNB will be having four rounds, okay, as per the brochure. Round one, round two and mop up round. You can call round 3 also and the stay vacancy round. See, round 1 and round 2 will be conducted by MCC, okay, and mop up round and the stay vacancy round. We don't have it very clear indication that how it will be conducted. Okay, in the previous bulletin they had mentioned that it will be conducted by NBE, okay. And in online mode or offline mode, that's also not very clear as of now. We are also waiting on the seat matrix to get released for DNB. And the seat matrix that got released for All India, Kota, Deemed University, IP, AMU and other central universities on Intra website, that's provisional. And after the verification process, they will make it live on mcc.nic.in. That's why you say you will see it's coming soon. So, and how is the sequence? First state round, how you can balance out your state round and your All India. So round one, All India has already started and you have the result date also and you have joining date as well. Another state like as per current update, Tamil Nadu registration is going to close today. Pondicherry registration is already closed and the registration process for Punjab has started. So gradually all other state will put their notification. It doesn't mean that you will get the result before round one of All India Quota. After round one All India Quota only you will get the result. Okay. So you join the college, okay, and then only all in your state counseling round one is will be published. So the sequence is round one All India Quota, then round one state, then round two All India Quota, then round two state. So the rule says if you joined in round one All India Quota, you need to submit the document, you need to pay the fee. There was other question also, if you want to join in round one for deemed university, do you need to pay the complete fee or partial? Last year due to COVID, they had like given this flexibility, you can pay the partial fee because there was some kind of budget issue in paying the tuition fee at a time. But this time, there is no surety that you will be having same flexibility. You pay the fee, you submit the document, you join the college. Now you have the liberty to upgrade up to round two. You can't upgrade in round mop-up round. Okay. Now if you get any seat upgraded in round two, then what happens? You need to join that upgraded seat. Okay. You must join it. And after joining the seat, you are not eligible to participate in other counseling process. You have to pay that seat leaving penalty, then only you can get the documents and other things back. In case you don't get your seat upgraded in round two, then you are allowed to leave the seat. You can leave the seat what you got in round one, and there is no penalty. There will be time frame given to you, and within that time frame you can leave the seat without any penalty, without any security deposit getting forfeited, and you can go for state round two. Okay, in case you didn't get any seat until round two, okay, or then still you are eligible for state round two. So you need to balance out, because in a state round you are going for government colleges, you have better chances than All India Quota for some state which are low merit state. Okay, so you need to balance that counseling process. Okay, I'll take this question, whether upgradation is allowed from second round counseling of deemed universities to mop-up round for central university. No, once you get in second round, after second round there is no upgradation, that's thumb rule. And after second round you get the seat, you join the seat, you are not eligible to participate in any the state council because your document is seized by the college. Okay, and in order to get it back you need to pay the full seat leaving penalty. Next question, what is the process of counseling of I think we already discussed, and talking about the NRI category. So in order to convert your means Indian to NRI, there was like time frame given up to 10 of today, and those candidates who were interested, they had required to send an email with all the documents. Okay, if you haven't done it, then you will get the chance in next round and mop-up round also. There is nothing to panic, still you can apply as NRI in the second round and mop-up round. Okay, whether NRI candidate are eligible for management quota as well? Yes, if you are NRI candidate, then it's very important question, star mark question, very very important question. You are NRI candidate, okay, then are you eligible for management seat as well? Yes, NRI candidate are eligible for management quota seat as well. You are not eligible, you can select management quota seat also, and as per merit you can get. You are not eligible for any kind of minority. You come under Muslim minority or Jain minority, you are not eligible to take the benefit of that minority. Okay, And next question, these are the documents which you need to have at the time of joining. You need to have that allotment letter, that's very important. Based on allotment letter and fee structure, you can get the loan from bank also. If you want to get loan from bank, then you need to keep the discussion started from now with bank manager, and you need to have some commitment from their side that the day you are able to produce the allotment letter and all other fee structure, in couple of days they should be able to disperse the amount, because you will be getting some like 1 week or less than that time for joining formalities. Okay, and you don't want to go on the last date, you keep a couple of days backup or bandwidth. Admit card, your scorecard, your mark sheet of MBBS, okay, internship completion certificate, MBBS degree certificate. Even you don't have the degree certificate, provisionally also work, okay. Permanent and registration certificate by MCI or state, high school certificates, and candidates must carry their like PAN card or driving license, voter ID, which is ID proof, and candidates should bring your category certificate. Okay, one more question that I will take. In case you are coming from OBC, you got the seat allotted in OBC and you go for joining, so what will happen in case you don't have OBC but you feel selected in the category at the time of category change OBC, your seat will get cancelled. Your seat will get cancelled, and in next round you can participate as a general category. So one round will be wasted, but you can't change the category now. Whatever category is mentioned in your scorecard, that will be your category. And in all India registration process, you can't change your mobile number and registration email ID. That will be taken automatically from your NBE registration, and the field, the option won't be editable. Okay, so I have covered like most of the thing, and like how to do the choice filling, that's the most important part. The choice filling is the most important part, because choice filling is the only thing that you give as input to the counseling authority, and based on that input they allow to you the college. So for example, you have your three options: general medicine, pediatrics, and you got rank of let's say 10,000, real scenario, 10,000 rank, and you have option first medicine, then pediatrics, and then say respiratory medicine. Okay, then how the candidate should do the choice filling? First of all, you should have list of the colleges, all the government colleges, from top to bottom based on their ranking, for branch wise. For medicine, which is the top college, which is the second college from the top, which is the 10th college from the top, and which college you should put on bottom. Okay, so this list you must have. If you don't have, then you can avail our paid guidance services. We will able to provide you such details. Okay, now how we need to start? You need to have that list for general medicine, you need to have that list for pediatrics, you need to have that list based on the colleges. A particular college may be good for general medicine but not for radio diagnosis. Okay, so you need to select the ranking of the colleges. That will come with like your experience, your like how well you know, or like in any group you are associated, and you can ask there or you can come to us. So you have that ranking for all three branches: medicine, pediatrics, and respiratory medicine. Now how to start? You are going to do the choice filling for DNB also. Okay, so you have that list for DNB as well, like top to bottom. Okay, now how will you start? It all depends on like your preference. If you are going for pediatrics branch, only if you don't get medicine, and you are going for respiratory medicine only in case you don't get, you are going for respiratory medicine only if you don't get pediatrics. This is one scenario you might be having. The branch is most preferred for you. Other scenario, you are looking for decent college also at the same time, and you want to go for best branch also. Okay, so how should you start? First you put all India government colleges, because any government college you take, you won't be having any kind of like patient flow issue or any kind of thing. You will be getting better learning opportunity there, except few options available in deemed in DNB in Maharashtra and New Delhi. Okay, so you select the government colleges for particular medicine, and then you select DNB, and then you select pediatrics, come in colleges. Then you select D&B pediatrics. Then you select respiratory medicine government colleges, and then respiratory medicine D&B hospitals. It is based on like your preference. If you want to go for other branch only, if you don't get medicine, then this is the preference. But if you want, you are looking for like a decent college also, and you can compromise your branch, then how you should do the choice filling? You need to have kind of like boundary line in your ranking, that these are the average D&B hospitals. You can put all the government colleges, but these are the average government average D&B hospitals, okay, for each and every branch, okay. And you put all your government colleges, followed by that you put all the good D&B hospitals, okay, and then leave that below average or average D&B hospital for rest, okay. Then you do the same thing for pediatrics. You put all government college pediatrics, and then good D&B hospitals for pediatrics. The same thing for respiratory medicine. And now whichever chunk from D&B hospital you had left out, okay, that you put in the sequence: medicine chunk, then pediatric chunk, and then respiratory medicine. So that in the bottom you should have only those options from D&B. Or even you want to like remove those options, it's up to you. You don't want to go for like average D&B hospitals, then you can leave that option. If you are thinking you can get better from state counseling, so this should be the approach. There are there are mistakes that you will do. You put like as per your analysis, you are thinking based on last year prediction, last year cutoff, you get particular college, the chances is high, or you go to the set of colleges where you are having high chance to get the seat, you put all the colleges on top. So how it is going to impact you? If you due to some positive shift this year, if you are like getting a seat in better colleges, then you won't be able to get that college, because the cursor will the software will move through the list, okay, and it will move through complete list given by you, then only it will go for other candidate. So until unless it's looking for complete list, and the moment it finds that this seat is available for you, it will give you that seat, it will allot you that seat, and it won't look at the remaining option. Means the remaining option are ignored. So you get the first option, the remaining good options are ignored. So always put like good option on top and poor option or average option in the later sequence. Okay, the video is getting very lengthy, so but I wanted to cover so many topics in this, so that is kind of like a master key for you, and you get many dots clear. So thank you for watching, and we'll meet again. Goodbye and take care.